Miranda is listening in. She can hear everything you said. So you said a trifle mess there, Miranda.
You're right, love.
On reflection.
Hello.
Hello, darling.
I think it's better than a three-year-old's attempt at a trifle, I have you know. I am comic relief MasterChef Champagne.
Yes, yes,
yeah, you are. You are.
Thank you.
You're reigning champagne. Reigning.
Yes.
It's only because Ruby and Claudia were so bad.
So bad. Well, luckily for us all, Miranda, you're not cooking tonight, are you?
I'm not cooking tonight. No, I wish I was slightly with my knee issue, but I am dancing tonight. Supposedly, good luck, everyone. I'll tell you, this is how it started this morning.
Good morning, Miranda!
Good morning, Chris!
Would you like to hear about today's task?
I'm a bit nervous, but okay.
You'll be performing a fantastic Latin routine to one of the most iconic dance tracks, I've Had the Time of My Life, from the Dirty Dancing soundtrack. And yes, there will be a big lift moment, and you'll be dancing with Strictly's Pasha.
No!
Yes!
I love Strictly so much, but how am I going to dance? Because only this morning could I vaguely stand up on my knee.
Good luck, really, Miranda! Yes. Off you go in Manchester!
Help me!
With only 9 hours to go before her performance in front of 120 people and the nation, Miranda was straight off to meet her dance teachers, Pasha and Katya.
Look at the Strictly professionals!
Come on, give me a little bit.
Bit wary.
Okay. We don't want to.
What about
not sexy yet? But it's getting there. It's,
really?
Yeah.
I think you should grab her hips and show it how it's done.
A little bit more. Yeah, it's getting focus here. Focus.
And there was a surprise in store.
I'm gonna cry.
Her friend and co-star from Miranda, Sarah Hadland, has come to lend her support by dancing in the challenge as well, as have local dance troupe Dance Syndrome.
Team Comic Relief!
Wow!
I'm speechless.
I know who's wearing the sexiest clothes out of us.
And you come to me and you'll be flying. So you coming,
dropping,
and...
So the question is, what has Miranda Hart managed to pull together for tonight? Well, only this! Look at this! Wow! Yes, it's our very own Strictly Come Dancing Extravaganza among the grandeur of Manchester Town Hall. Miranda, you're feeling pretty smug at the moment about that.
Pre-dancing smug.
Yes, we'll talk about that in a minute,
yes,
but well
and
done.
I put up this glitter ball earlier, yeah. All the glitter balls around.
We did that. Yes, it was quite a struggle, but between us, our combined heights, we got it together.
Yes, it does help. I wanted to say, I mean, as we saw, you haven't done all this by yourself. You've also been hampered by injury.
Yes.
So, Sarah, what have you done today to make yourself feel proud?
Oh, very good, very nice. Good. I like that. Heather would be thrilled with you. I've tried to supply a bit of moral support.
Yes,
and hopefully make up for the lack of knee.
Okay, well, let's just talk about that. How are you feeling about the dance? How confident about the performance? Because this is one element.
Obviously, without the knee, I'm naturally gifted at dance.
Yes.
But I am hampered.
You
today.
Are. Anyway, we'll see just how much you're hampered a bit later. Gosh. When you come back, Miranda Hart will be dancing. Woo. See you then.
Oh, it's going to be great.
Yes.
Very excited. Thank goodness for Sarah. But good to see that Miranda is off the crutches, at least.
Love her. She would have been so excited for this otherwise. Anyway, please support Miranda. If you can afford to donate, please do it. Just text the word March to 70005.
Yeah, and we'll see her strutting her stuff very shortly. Cannot wait.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time has come. Please welcome to our very special Strictly stage, Dance Syndrome from Manchester, who are beneficiaries of some of your donations from Comic Relief, and our very special stars tonight, Sarah Hadland and Miranda Hart. Now
I never felt like this before. Yes, I swear it's a truth, and I owe it all to you.
'Cause I had the time of my life, and I owe it all to you.
I've been waiting for so long, now I finally found someone to stand by me.
The judges are loving it. Everybody's loving it. Oh, this is standing ovation almost. Miranda, you love Strictly. How was that for you?
Yeah, that was all right. I'm now in a lot of pain, but it was fun.
You are in a lot of pain,
you
I
don't,
know.
You don't feel the pain when you're doing it. Now I'm like, oh! But it was really fun. What a great partner.
Oh, what a great partner. Yeah. Yes, I mean, Pasha, does Miranda have natural rhythm?
Absolutely. And if not for that knee, she would be like, hurricane here.
Who knows? Now, obviously, the knee has hampered you. Sarah, you really helped out with the lifts and everything there. Thank you so much.
I have to say, you know, she's been really brave with her knee, so really people have to donate. Please donate.
Absolutely, she's being so brave. Now, tomorrow is another day, and you know what that means.
Another challenge.
Now, you know you're going to be in Birmingham.
I know that. That's all I know.
Tune in tomorrow, Chris Evans' breakfast show on Radio 2, and you'll find out, and so will Miranda, exactly what she's doing. We'll see you then. Bye.
I've got a feeling that is the last time we're going to see Miranda and Pasha together.
I think you're right. She's got the moves.
She's started a rumour there. Anyway, yes, if you want to show your support for Miranda, please pick up the phone and text the word March 7005.
Yes, John and Greg, if you do us the honours of the T's and C's.
Do this in a MasterChef style.
MasterChef style, yeah, go
on. All right, John Comic Relief will get £5 to support people living tough lives. You got 3 minutes! Across Africa and here in the UK.
Yes, but the thing is, they've got to be 16 or over, and they've got to ask the bill payer for permission.
I don't agree.
Well, you're going to have to agree. You're going to see.
Well, I don't agree.
You're going to have to see. And for more information, go to bbc.com/Windows Day.
Is that what you want to do?
That's what you've got to do.
All right. Thank you, lads. Thank you so much for that. Thank you.
Now, back in January, I visited a women's project in Malawi that's funded by Comic Relief. It teaches young mothers to be about pregnancy and warns them of the dangers of not reaching a hospital in time to give birth. Today, I was at Incheu Hospital in Malawi to visit a special project for women funded by Comic Relief. This wonderful welcome was from just some of the ladies who attend this project. And after the singing and the dancing, the women congregate for their regular Safe Motherhood meeting. Pregnancy can be a dangerous time for women in developing countries, and these sessions provide life-saving advice for new mothers and mothers-to-be. An emergency at the hospital brings home the importance of the women's group.
It's pretty horrific in there, actually. This lady gave birth yesterday and she started bleeding after giving birth, which is incredibly dangerous. It's just blood everywhere on the bed. How is the mother doing now? How is she?
She has to go to the theatre so that they can examine her properly.
If that lady was at home now in her village, what do you think would happen to her?
Maybe they would be thinking that the bleeding will stop and they would be taking a lot of time before they'd say about coming to the hospital. So I think she would die.
She's in the best place here.
Yeah.
If left untreated, severe bleeding can kill a woman in just a couple of hours.
Fingers crossed for her. She's back with her baby. She's been incredibly lucky because she lost so much blood. They had to give her a blood transfusion. And I mean, the fact that they found a match, but that would only have happened here in the hospital. And it looks like everything's going to be okay. Mungu ela ujembele wabwino, likutipa ngira ifeyo, ubwino, mamiti mwatu. Puzita guno, ineso anawundumaga puzita zomwezo, ndiwinari ense midimo. And before this group was established, how little was their knowledge about childbirth and about being pregnant? The nurses in the maternity ward really have their hands full caring for mothers and their babies.
baby is literally just being born. Yeah. And it needs to have the fluid drained from its lungs. Is the baby okay?
Oh.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's okay.
These two ladies' children are hooked up to these oxygen concentrators here on the floor because both were born premature and they need some extra oxygen to help them in the early stages.
Access to this kind of medical expertise and equipment is only available at the hospital.
Comic Relief funds a brilliant project that teaches young girls and women to come here to the hospital to deliver their babies in safety rather than doing it at home. An educational session costs £5, and if you'd like to donate, you can do by texting the word MARCH to 70005. It really is a matter of life and death.